Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Have you ever looked around and noticed just how outdated some of our infrastructure has become? In the US, crumbling bridges and delayed trains are increasingly seen as just the way things are. According to the American Society of Civil Engineers, around 43% of all bridges in the country are over 50 years old. Many are even classified as structurally deficient. Meanwhile, across the Pacific, China is rewriting the rules of infrastructure. In 2023 alone, over 10,000 bridges were built or rebuilt. Some of them world-class megastructures that span entire seas. The contrast in transportation infrastructure is even more striking. In New York City, the subway averages just 16 km/h, and delays caused by aging equipment are a daily occurrence. Meanwhile, China's high-speed rail network races ahead at 356 kilometers per hour, with a total length exceeding 45,000 kilometers, accounting for more than 70% of the world's high-speed rail mileage. Take California's high-speed rail as an example. After 15 years of planning and debate, only a 190-kilometer stretch has been completed, with costs ballooning from $33 billion to over $128 billion. In contrast, China builds comparable rail lines in 40% less time and at 30% lower cost, without compromising quality or safety. The gap is just as visible in energy infrastructure. In parts of the U.S., aging power grids struggle to withstand extreme weather, often resulting in widespread blackouts. Meanwhile, China has built the world's largest clean energy system. Just one facility, the Baihetan Hydropower Station, can supply electricity to over 40 million households. While the U.S. is still debating pipeline repairs, China has already completed thousands of kilometers of natural gas and oil pipelines, meeting the world's highest technical and construction standards. Behind these numbers lies a fundamental difference in development models. In the U.S., infrastructure projects often stall amid lengthy approval processes and political gridlock. In China, powerful coordination, homegrown engineering innovation, and a long-term vision turn blueprints into reality at scale and speed. Want to know how these engineering miracles come to life? Let's dive into the construction front lines of some of China's most awe-inspiring projects, like the Deep Earth Taklamakan-1, the Shenjiang High-Speed Railway Tunnel, and the Changtai Yangtze River Bridge. and see what the future of infrastructure really looks like. In today's global infrastructure landscape, China is redefining what's possible, building at a speed and scale that is simply breathtaking. While many nations struggle to repair or upgrade aging infrastructure, China has launched a sweeping infrastructure revolution, reshaping geography and transforming lives through one mega project after another. In the remote terrain basin of Xinjiang, the roar of drilling machines never stops at the Deep Earth Taklamakan-1 Well. This is no ordinary project. It's a direct challenge to the Earth's limits. While shale gas drilling in the United States hovers around 3,000 meters, Chinese engineers, using an entirely domestically developed automated rig, have pushed the drill bit to a staggering 1,910 meters below ground. This makes the Taklamakan-1 well the deepest in Asia and the second deepest scientific borehole in the world. It also marks a historic breakthrough in China's deep Earth exploration capabilities. Engineers faced extreme heat, pressure, and complex geological formations, yet they overcame these with relentless innovation. Every meter drilled pushed the boundaries of what humans can achieve. It is said that after drilling 9,000 meters underground at the Deep Earth Taklamakan-1 Well, Chinese engineers broke through rock layers that date back 500 million years. They then converted seismic waveforms from 9,000 to 14,000 meters below the surface into audible frequencies, allowing us to hear the sounds from deep within the Earth. Meanwhile, under the Pearl River estuary, the construction of the Shenjiang high-speed railway tunnel is just as intense. At a depth of 106 meters beneath the seabed, the massive Shenjiang tunnel boring machine is advancing at a steady 15 meters per day. This project has already broken records, becoming the deepest shield tunneling project in the world for high-speed rail. While New York's century-old subway tunnels often experience delays due to aging infrastructure, China has reached a 100% localization rate for TBM technology. From design and manufacturing to deployment, every step is domestically driven. This tunnel not only broke depth records, but also set 5 global engineering benchmarks, including breakthroughs in cable imaging and tailpipe grouting. These advances have significantly improved construction efficiency, safety, and reliability. Even the New York Times couldn't help but express amazement. In the Pearl River estuary, Chinese engineers connected 6.7 kilometers of undersea tunnel segments with a margin of error of just 3 millimeters, like assembling the Lego blocks in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. Meanwhile, Boston's Big Dig overran its budget by 220% and resulted in a fatal ceiling collapse. Now shift your view to the Yangtze River, where the Changtai Yangtze River Bridge is rewriting engineering history. Its 350-meter-tall cable-stayed tower, equal to a 115-story building, is now the tallest of its kind in the world. But it's not just the height that impresses. The bridge's innovative flat-deck design integrates high-speed rail, expressways, and local roads all on a single level, maximizing efficiency and minimizing land use. The main waterway bridge of this river crossing channel is a cable-stayed bridge with a main span of 1,176 meters. While both Tianxingzhou Channel Bridge and Luanzhou Channel Bridge use a steel truss arch bridge with a main span of 388 meters. Its average area is approximately 5,400 square meters, which is the size of 13 basketball courts. The underwater foundation for the tower piers of the bridge uses 23,000 tons of steel. That's the steel of three Eiffel Towers. Engineers faced enormous challenges, such as maintaining vertical precision for ultra-tall towers and hoisting enormous steel beams across vast spans. Yet, through cutting-edge techniques and bold innovation, these obstacles were conquered. In stark contrast, California's high-speed rail project remains mired in cost overruns and technical delays. China, by comparison, is completing similar projects 40% faster and at 30% less cost, thanks to its powerful industrial base, streamlined coordination, and decades of accumulated engineering expertise. But these mega projects are just part of the picture. China's infrastructure miracle is also evident in its expanding transportation network. As of today, China's high-speed rail network has surpassed 25,000 miles, more than 70% of the global total. From the icy plains of Harbin to the tropical shores of Sanya, from coastal megacities like Shanghai to the high-altitude plateau of Lhasa, this network crisscrosses the country like a web of steel dragons, uniting cities and boosting regional economies. These rail lines have dramatically reduced travel times and improved quality of life, while also driving regional economic integration. Throughout the process, engineers have tackled an array of extreme challenges: Arctic cold, searing heat, fragile ecosystems, deserts, and more. For example, the Qinghai-Tibet Railway posed three world-class challenges: high-altitude hypoxia, permafrost, and environmental fragility. Chinese engineers responded with pioneering solutions like elevated bridges in place of roadbeds, ventilated stone foundations, and thermal stabilizing rods, ensuring the safe and sustainable operation of one of the most remarkable railways on Earth. China's bridge building capabilities are equally remarkable. Beyond the Changtai Yangtze River Bridge, a growing list of world-class bridges continue to break records. For instance, the Beipanjiang Bridge, with a vertical clearance of 565.4 meters from deck to riverbed, holds the title of the world's highest bridge. The Hutong Yangtze River Bridge, spanning 1,092 meters, is the world's first cable-stayed bridge combining both railway and highway functions with a span exceeding 1 kilometer. The construction of these bridges not only demonstrates China's world-leading expertise in bridge engineering, but also reflects the spirit of bold innovation and technical ambition among Chinese engineers. In these projects, China has adopted a variety of advanced structural designs such as suspension bridges, cable-stayed bridges, and arch bridges. It has also employed cutting-edge construction methods, including prefabricated assembly, incremental launching, and bridge rotation. These techniques have significantly improved construction efficiency and quality across the nation. From cross-sea bridges to hydropower giants, from high-speed rail networks to clean energy megabases, Chinese engineers are pushing boundaries again and again, turning the impossible into reality. They are building, quite literally, the backbone of a nation's rise. These projects show that China doesn't just export infrastructure, it exports a complete development solution. Even the New York Times admitted, Chinese infrastructure is reshaping the global economic order. So how is China defining the next century of human progress? While the US is still fixing highways from the last century, China is already exploring the ultimate future of infrastructure. With each mega project built, China continues to overcome world-class engineering challenges, Through innovative techniques and advanced construction methods, earning it the moniker Infrastructure Maniac. Moreover, China has undertaken major projects in numerous other countries, each emblematic of its development drive. Behind China's global leadership in infrastructure lies not only a leap in technology, but also the support of a mighty nation. For over a century, from the devastation at the founding of the People's Republic of China, it has been the successive struggles of generations of Chinese engineers that have painted the picture of today's prosperous China. And yet, this is not the end for China. In the future, the Infrastructure Maniac will continue to help more developing countries modernize, create new opportunities for development, and build a better, more livable world for all. Each bridge, every road, and every project connects cities and countrysides, the present and the future, China and the world. Chinese infrastructure has not only reshaped the face of China, but also exemplified the strength, spirit, and speed of the nation. The Infrastructure Maniac will never stop. What miracles do you think Chinese infrastructure will create in the next decade? Please share your thoughts in the comments.